And we're doing a month strong challenge, as y'all might know or heard of, for people that invited you into this group. Kevin, he is running the show, and Persistent Progress is hosting for him, creating this platform for us to expand a positive community and just kind of just network and create positive spirits and many different avenues that we can create by everybody coming together. Everybody that'll be in this group today will have some type of backgrounds or different career paths and choices, and not even career paths that they're choosing to be their final destination through their journey of careers and everything of working. So people will be looking to expand and grow in many different ways as they are coming to the group as part of the purpose, whether it's just for motivating, influence others, just looking for any type of reason to stay consistent and dedicated to something. Everything is looking, is able to be found here in this group today. Kevin wanted to do this, as we spoke before. He wanted to do this morning rise challenges, and this is solely for me and Kevin to keep consistent and do this twice a week. But we do ask for anybody else that is a part of this that you stick to as well with us, because it does help motivate us, because anything that we do, we're able to do it better by holding each other accountable. So I want to say thank you for checking in this early in the morning, doing it even twice a week. It's definitely dedication. It's definitely not easy. Some nights are harder than others, and to get back up the following morning and get on here definitely takes some commitment. So I just want to, I'm reading this book right now called Unshakable. It's by this life coach. He's pretty famous, Tony Robbins. And he's basically speaking on financial literacy and wealth, especially in the ballpark of people who have retirement and savings accounts and stuff like that. And basically, he's putting information into this book that a lot of people who have these accounts don't know. And it's basically as understand the tricks in the trade to having a 401k and a 457b or 403b. So he was writing in his book as him being a life coach, and I just want to kind of read over his little quick page just to let y'all know for what he's saying, because I kind of try to be a life coach and influencer and go around the same path what he's doing. So here we go. He said that anyone can get lucky and win the lottery. Anyone can pick a winning stock from time to time. But if you want to achieve lasting financial success, you need more than just an occasional lucky break. So even he's speaking about finance in the book, but that goes for any type of success. That you, majority of people that are successful in this world, they didn't just get that one lucky shot and just that's how they made it and that's how they sustained being there. It was whatever they did to get there and how they maintained to stay there this whole time. So I'm gonna keep reading that. I see this in every area of life, whether it's sustaining a happy and passionate marriage for more than a half a century, losing weight and keeping it off for decades, or building a business worth billions of dollars. The key is to recognize these consistently success patterns and to model them, using them to guide the decisions you want to make in your own life. These patterns provide the playbook for your success. So with saying that part is what I speak on for Persistent Progress, is that you kind of find the patterns that from the people, whoever you idolize, and you use as a blueprint, as what I say. That's why I try to live my life like that. If I do something great, I want to be able to record it, write it down, share it, and use it as a blueprint for the next person coming after me. Same way a parent would do for their kids. You don't want them to bump their heads and make the same mistakes that they're doing. So this guy that he's saying that he's basically tried to crack the code by interviewing many, many successful people, 50 people, so to speak. And he's trying to figure out that how he can basically, all these traits that these people are doing, how can you break them down into just of a few things, because it's so broad, so many different successful people all over the world doing being different in different ways. And he said that, remember that complexity can be the enemy of execution. So what he means by that is, see if you can be able to, don't get too broad that it almost frustrates you, because at the end of the day, you need execution to get goals accomplished. And so with doing that, that you want to keep it simple sometimes. Sometimes you can just bring down the basic things of being consistent, dedicated, and just always looking to become more educated. Those are kind of the basic things that's going to keep that open mind, that's going to keep you moving forward, is a simplicity of things. So I just wanted to touch on that real quick from what I was reading last night, and it just hit me. I was like, wow, I think that'd be good for what we need to hear and just to know, because it definitely kind of motivated me to keep going and to learn about this finance that he's teaching right now in this book. Go ahead, Kev, knock us out, man.
All right. See, you know how we do it every single week. We always start out with a motivational video. I kind of just take time to look at some stuff. We're gonna get started. We got some. Hopefully, you have your pens, pads, papers, all that fun stuff, and we'll get started.
Do you know that every living soul gets exactly the same amount of time? You get all there is. A hobo sleeping under a bridge or on a park bench that has no material possessions, none. That person gets exactly the same amount of time as the most productive industrialist in the world. We all get exactly the same amount of time. So it's what we do with the time that makes the difference.
You know what I hear? I hear the clock ticking. That's what I hear. And the end is nigh, and time waits for no man. Life goes by, and it goes by quick. Don't waste those years. Don't waste them. Live them. Fight that ticking clock with everything you got. So, like the end of a hard day, you can put your head down with ease, satisfied.
And it drives me crazy when people say that they don't have enough time to go to the gym for 45 minutes a day and work out, or to do something for 45 minutes to an hour a day to improve, if it is physically improve or if it is mentally to improve. Imagine you read 1 hour a day about history. How much you will learn after 365 hours. So it drives me nuts because we have 24 hours a day. We sleep 6 hours a day, so that gives you still 18 hours.
How you address it is you face it. You face it every day. You face it every single day of your life where you say, okay, like if you're fat, you need to lose weight. It's patience. It's patience in this fact of accepting who you are right now. I'm fat. I don't like myself. Accepting the fact that if you lose 3 or 4 pounds, that's a huge accomplishment. You have to live in your own world. You cannot judge yourself. That's why social media and all these things are horrible. You can't judge yourself off of the so-called competition that we have made up in our mind. The things that, how people look, how people act, how smart someone is. This is a race that you run completely alone.
You want to improve? You want to get better? You want to get on a workout program or a clean diet or start a new business? You want to write a book or make a movie or build a house or a computer or an app? Where do you start? You start right here. When do you start? You start right now. So stop thinking about it. Stop dreaming about it. Start doing it. Take that first step and make it happen.
Awesome. Awesome. So one of the big things that comes from this video is that a lot of people don't use their time very wisely. So time management is a huge thing that people don't really understand. And it's really important for us that, like, as people and as a group, to really understand that all we need to see is our growth, right? We just need to see it just going up. So it's time to not waste any time and grow. So our biggest challenge today is we're going to do an assignment, pretty much. And I want you to write out your three biggest flaws. The reason I want you to write out your three biggest flaws is because I want you to understand that these flaws are just obstacles that are stopping you from becoming what you want to become. Every single day that we're here, every single day that we wake up, every single day that we do something, it's we're always going to be faced with these obstacles. And the way that we deal with these obstacles, the way that we find solutions, the way that we think about these obstacles, you know, it's that's the main part of our growth. A lot of people give up, and we shouldn't, because of the fact that realistically, at the end of the day, we are here to help each other. And yes, it said that you should be doing it as an individual, but when you have a team behind you, you literally are here and one step ahead, because we are all trying to do what we can to help each other out. So go ahead. We're going to take about 5 minutes. Go ahead and write down your three biggest flaws, and then we'll move on to the next point after that, okay? Too young, too fast, thought I was ready, but my time is bad, yeah. One life, too much to see. And I said, hey, I've had better days, yeah, I missed that train by a mile away, but please, don't cry for me. If you thought I was down, if you thought I was losing sleep, well, I'm still going hard 8 days a week. I can hold my breath when it gets too hard to breathe. Every lonely night, a teardrop in the sea. So don't cry for me.
Picking up the pieces from when I was number one. If you thought I was down, if you thought I was losing sleep, well, I'm still going hard 8 days a week. I can hold my breath when it gets too hard to breathe. Every lonely night, a teardrop in the sea. We'll be right back.
going in so late. What's wrong? I said I can't stay. Do I have to give a reason? It's just me, it's what I want. So how do we get here? 3 weeks now, we've been so caught up. Better if we do this on our own. Before I love you, na-na-na, I'm gonna leave you, na-na-na. Before I'm someone you leave behind, I'll break your heart so you don't break mine. Before I love you, na-na-na, I'm gonna leave you, na-na-na. Even if I am not here to stay, I still want your heart.
All right. Awesome, guys. So one of the big reasons I wanted you to do that is because a lot of people don't really ever kind of write out their own flaws, right? They just try to focus on the day, they try to focus on everything. So we're going to go through two steps. First is writing out your flaw that you already done. And then with that flaw, figuring out the solutions. And I'm just going to give you a hint. There shouldn't be just one solution for each flaw, right? There should be multiple solutions because we are faced with every different things each and every single day when we come with adversity and such. So these specific things are what make us into greater and better human beings. So if we're going to face this, we face it together and we face it many different ways. So now, one, make a promise to yourself that you're going to get over these flaws because these flaws should eventually become your strengths. And when a person asks you, what is your flaw? My flaw should realistically be that I will always have flaws, but I will always be working towards a greater growth for myself and a greater version of myself. So take the first step and write out your personal solutions, right? So your potential solutions. So we're going to wait, give out another probably 2 to 3 minutes, do that real quick, and then we can kind of share on our first set.
But your worst was still better than everybody. And I hate that, you heard me just say that, but I guess it's true. How many times do I lie in bed and tell myself a lie? How many times do I turn my head so my friends don't see me cry? I say that I'll be fine without you, I'll be better when you're gone. I swear I won't think about you when I'm dancing all night long. Someone else, I thought I'd be down for good, but my mindset.
All right, cool. So I know that this is kind of more hands-on. This is more of a, I want people to understand that, you know, with us, we don't just, you know, speak words, but we also try to put actions into place. And with that being said, this last part is going to be realistically your homework. So we're going to go, I'm going to go ahead and share mine. So my first flaw is impatience with others when they are unable to finish a task in a reasonable amount of time, mainly because I'm a very goal-oriented guy and I like to see things done in a specific way. And I always think about like multiple tasks at once, so I try to delegate the best I can. And when people don't finish their task, when I think that I give them an easy task and I'm doing the much more difficult task, that gets me really annoyed and impatient. So I said some of my solutions that I specifically have been working on is checking on them periodically before the due date to check their progress and see if I can offer any help. Ask to send their daily updates to ensure that we're staying on track. Asking them to like maybe document their day to see their optimal like time frame where they can actually complete the task that I've given them, and then see where I can help finish the task, like really just make it easier. My second flaw is just rushing results. I like to see, like, as a goal-oriented guy, so I like to see results very, very quickly. So as a stocks trader, I've always wanted to make money, so I always wanted to see the results now rather than later, but I have to realize that that's not how the stocks work, that's not how Forex works. So understanding the market and how it will move on its own, and that there's not a reason to rush it. Another thing is I've set my alarm usually about to every hour now just to go and back and check where like my investments are, just so that I can periodically understand like, hey, like this is going the way that I want it to go. This isn't going the way I want it to go, whatever it may be. So that if I needed to pull out of a trade, I would. And then three, it's just like really just trying to occupy your time with something else. So I like reading a book or playing video games or eating out, whatever it may be, and then coming back up to check on them. My third thing is staying focused. Obviously, you've seen it on these calls. I'm not always here just because of the fact that I do Forex trading. So when I see opportunities, I will send out a trade while also doing this. So multitasking is a very big thing. The big issue with it is because sometimes you miss out the smaller details on the things that you do. So it's really kind of really important for me. It's like as I am showing you all three of my flaws, you feel comfortable sharing your three flaws because of the fact that at the end of the day, we all should be wanting to get better. You see that each and every one of these flaws has more than one solution. Doing small exercises to test my focus, testing myself not only to focus on the task at a certain amount of time, revisit the task that I've done prior so to see if I was focused during that time, just to see if I can nail all the details of what I was supposed to do, whether I'm writing those details prior and then revisiting the details later, seeing if you check off every box, and then keeping a log of when I go off task. And it's been a lot, mainly because I'm dived into so much that I have to allow myself to say, this is my time for this, this is my time for this, this is my time for this. So I give myself usually about 30 to an hour for every task that I do now, just so that I can focus solely on that task. Yes, sir. All right. Cool. So, does anybody want to share their three flaws and just talk about some of their solutions that they came up with? Obviously, if you guys think that you can add to the solutions, definitely let me know. I don't mind to add to my own solutions as well. Everybody's afraid of their flaws. Is it too early? Too early for people? What's going on?
Give me 1 second, kid. I'm finishing up my last one right now. Got share mine.
Okay, from a scale of 1 to 10, while Dre's doing that, how was your weekend realistically? How are you mentally, and how are you really overall in this whole COVID world and everything that you did this weekend? From a 1 out of 10, put it in the chat box. How are you this week? I mean, how were you this past weekend? How are you today? Did you feel like you got stuff done, or did you not feel like it? Rate it yourself. I'm not going to ask questions. I'm just going to be like, oh, that's cool. Oh, okay. You know, it's because of the fact that we should all realistically, if we don't put a 10, then that means that we didn't do everything that we needed to do this weekend. My personal rating, I did a 6. So, can't wait to see yours.
I'm ready.
Go for it.
So my first flaw, and these are flaws I'm pretty aware of. I do a lot of self-evaluation a lot. That's a big thing with me. So my first one is being impatient. I might not show it all the time, but I'm very impatient. So if I'm not showing it on the outside, then I'm really feeling it on the inside. So I try to, my goal is to work on it by work on channeling my energy, because that I am aware of my impatience and what I am impatient about, but basically trying to find a way to transfer that energy into positive energy or into a positive influences on my life. And just even work on my transition period. So me just going from one activity to the next, that don't let the negative energy from that moment transfer to the next thing, where it's like it creates the vibe for my mood for the rest of the day or the rest of the hour. And so to speak, I'm able to be aware of whatever I'm impatient about, because I know I'm not perfect. There are going to be trying times. But because I am aware of that, I need to really hone in of eliminating that right there, like stopping it right there, and then being able to regroup myself to move forward onto the next thing and not necessarily fully carrying it with me, you know? So that's my first flaw. And I'm pretty, I guess, confident in what I need to do to work on that. My second flaw is being, I got a partly addictive personality to making money. So a strong trait. I've been having it since I was young. That making money has just been a big thrive for me. But as you know, as far as just your financial literacy, that the people who usually work the hardest hands-on with making money aren't the ones, or ones who probably want to get rich the most or the fastest, but they're the furthest away from it. So kind of really understanding that for the money bracket for that I'll be in, that those, there's like a point of unacceptable hours that you just almost working too much and it's almost not making sense. And to kind of hone that in and just to really to create balance for myself to still have that time for the things that you can't put a price value on. You know, you can't put a money number on. And so I think I'm going to try to really set like a goal for a number that I want to reach, if it's even in my savings account or somewhere where now that I have a happy spot that I've reached that goal for the amount of money that makes me feel comfortable, and then I can create more balance and versatility in my options for what I use my time for, besides just constantly trying to pick up overtime and just, you know, gotta go to work, gotta get this extra cash right here and there. So, and my third flaw is kind of more of in my head for self-awareness and my consciousness. So I don't know how much you are aware, like, well, I'm pretty sure everyone is aware of just that extra thought that's in your head. Like if you have thoughts in your head, it sounds like your voice, you know, cause like that's your own conscious and awareness. I've read books like that. It's kind of like psychology books. So just being kind of, I don't know if it's truly possible or not, which I kind of feel that it is, being kind of control of your consciousness and of your thinking and awareness. So like to really be in control, like I say, if you're sitting at the dinner table, for example, and you know you don't need seconds, or you know you've already ate, but you want to eat to get full. You want to eat to the point because it's so good that you want to eat to the point that your stomach is now full and now you have the itis. But knowingly, you're sitting at the table looking at your empty plate, you're like, I don't need to get a second one. I want to have more control over not going up and getting that second plate or not going up, you know what I mean, and doing that when I know I don't need to. So my positive, or my way to be positive to revert from that on that flaw is I actually did it last night. So hopefully I could probably stick to that. Maybe it'll work better. It's like, for instance, for dinner, because I like eating to get full, basically. After I finish like my plate or whatever, and I know like, okay, I've ate, like I'm good. Go and brush my teeth. So now I ain't brush my teeth. I know like, okay, I'm not about to go eat no more food or eat anything else. So I know one, it's gonna taste nasty as hell. And then two, I'm not about to try to rebrush my teeth again later on in the night. So that was kind of my positive reinforcement for one of my flaws.
Perfect, man. Yeah, I mean, that's like, it's a, in itself, everything that you want to do, right? And at the end of the day, it's like you testing yourself and then really putting, testing your wit. Like, I did the same thing yesterday. I mean, from going out to eat and doing everything like that, it's always telling yourself, when you go to a new place, you will, you know, eat their food. And I just had sushi. So I was like, I don't need all that. And then I came home, my dad made food, and I was like, I don't need all that either. So I ended up going to sleep. I woke up and I was just like, I gotta tell him I don't want this food. Just because it for me, it's putting me into a perspective of understanding that my flaw is I love to eat. But understanding how to control that with the many things that I can do, like sleep, I can play video games, I can try to get time to go past, like all those different things. Like that's the big thing about this. So now that you all have your three flaws and you talk about the ways that you're going to fix them, right? And you've already committed to fixing these flaws. Now write down for your homework assignment, obviously, because I actually have to open earlier today. So it's going to be a kind of a short call. It's is now write down, for your homework for Friday is write down your three desirable flaws that you have. And with that being said, repeat the same process. Promise yourself that you're going to get over these future flaws, because the moment that you're talking about these future flaws is the moment that you are speaking it into or writing into or thinking it into existence. So if you want to be successful, you want to have that bank account, you want to have all these different things, speaking to existence, there's going to be downfalls. That's just what it is. But now understanding that this is an uphill battle. Your uphill battle is with yourself, not with anything else. So create the time for the thing you want, and then don't make excuses. It's really, really important for you to understand that each and every single asset of your life, facet of your life, it shouldn't be based off of the things that were your past, but the things that you will do in your future. If you want to create this successful business, if you want to create this successful group, if you want to create this successful time in your life to do things now, then write it out, figure it out, plan it out so that you can make sure it happens. Because the people who are rich, people who are doing the smaller things that they need to do, they're doing it because they can. And if you want to be successful, you want to be great, you want to be all these different things, then say that. Don't be okay with where you are now, but be okay with where you are down the line. And once you get to that point down the line, then don't be okay with that point, and then continue to keep going into more of what you want to do. So that's all I got today, realistically. It's just realistically understand that you are your biggest growth. So you are the biggest reason that you stop growing, that you stop developing. And the bigger reason that you do continue to grow and you do continue to develop, because you as yourself need to press yourself into wanting more. And if you don't want more, then, you know, that's something that you have to, consider to yourself. But realistically, always desire more, want more, and become great. Dre, you have anything to wrap up, man?
Yeah, I got one last thing to say. This community that we created and that we got expanding right now for even the new people that we have in the group today, and even people we got to follow through, I think a nice little goal or task, which I'm going to try to do. And if you want to do it, you know, you guys are welcome to, but try to pass on a positive spirit to someone else outside of this group. So someone that doesn't attend these Zoom meetings, basically try to provide a positive spirit. And so when I say this positive spirit, this positive environment, I mean basically something that they can take with them for when they leave, for when y'all separate. And when I say this, there's a true influence. So not necessarily of picking somebody's spirits up for the day, but something that you're actually passing on to them. So for instance, if somebody's looking for some type of need and something to read or something to stimulate their mind, that you're like advising them of a book to check out and they actually go do it. Because if they don't go do it, then that doesn't necessarily count. That means that they just listened to you and went on about their day. You had a good attempt, but it wasn't effective. It wasn't successful. So it's like, if you could do that for like one person where they truly like listen to you and they go take action, then that's like your one positive environment that you have created. So now that it's in full effect of what you did, it wasn't just your attempt. But sometimes we say, oh, at least we tried, you know, that we can sleep better at night because we tried. But sometimes trying is a little bit enough. It's like, see how actually effective you can be. So that's one thing I'm gonna try this week, to see what I can pass on or give to somebody that's like outside of the Zoom meeting. Because everybody that's really being these Zoom calls, I talk to on a regular basis anyway about positive, effective stuff, how we can become better. So now I basically need to find somebody outside of this group and see how effective I can be on them to influence them to do something positive or creative that they kind of take advice from me and they actually go attempt to do, and whether it's effective or not, if it works for them, but they at least try it, and that them trying to be open-minded, that's a positive thing to have. So that's my take on it, that you guys should, should try. That's what I'm doing this week, just to check it out and see, because what does it hurt? You're going to talk to somebody outside of this Zoom meeting anyway, so see if you can drop some positive influence and knowledge on them that they can actually go and apply to their life and see what they get out of it.
I have a question. Yes. Can you give an example of a potential flaw?
Like a potential flaw? Think about it this way. Like, let's say your business blows up and everything, right? One of the big flaws like with that is time management. So, and a lot of people don't like really in the sense of like when it comes to understanding like potential new flaws are these current flaws but elevated. So me being impatient is because I'm being impatient because I see this progress. So now understanding that time management is not becoming my issue, because I used to, because I would be more likely to focus on something else when I can't, or I don't focus on other things. Another could be not giving yourself any personal time, just because you are going to be so dived into what your business will be doing. Another could be treating yourself to dinner, whatever it may be. It's dependent on you, realistically. It's a mind game for yourself. But one of the big twos is just really focusing on like what you really desire to do, and whether that be saying that, hey, one of my big flaws will eventually be time management, because I gotta figure out how to balance my life, how to figure out how to balance my business, gotta make sure I have time for all my clients, how to figure out where everything is, and then figure out the solutions before they even come up, so that when you come back to this like a year from now, 6 months from now, a couple months from now, whatever it may be, and these flaws are actual reality, then you should be able to be like, I already have an answer. I don't got to worry about it. And then the moment that those happen, then you should be able to say, you know what? I'm going to go back. I'm going to go do what I need to do.
That makes sense. Okay. Thank you.
My three, I already know my three future flaws. Well, I'm assuming. Hopefully they don't become my future flaws. Mine is that I don't want to become, well, I guess it would be a flaw, I'm sorry. she's flaw being too strong or too proud or too stubborn to ask for help. I already kind of have that now, but I feel like once I become more even financially stable or wealthier than I am, that could be something that could easily grow in me. And I won't necessarily know it until almost too late, and I gotta bring myself back down to reality or to better myself. Another flaw leave my kids and family, but let them grow into their own life and personality for who they want to be, who God has them planned out to be. I think that's just part of something that even me with my family is that we love hard, and sometimes we just want to steer them or guide them to what we think is best for them, but in all actuality, it's about their life, and they need to go and try and see what's best for them. My third one would be not be controlling and just let others be held accountable, and for basically me working with somebody and because I don't feel like that they're going to take it as serious as me or whatever, then I'll just almost take over their work, and I just, because I know I can hold myself to that type of standard. When and all, you need to still let people try, because they can eventually, they might impress themselves, or it might be what they need is to be held accountable with that much pressure with them, because they might actually expand and grow. But if you just keep handicapping them, then how can they reach their full potential? But I could definitely see as myself caring so much that that'd be something that I would do, which is kind of just be controlling in a sense and just take over.
Fact, man. I mean, I understand that. I understand it all. So it's like, you know, this is all things that we grow together. I mean, there's 12 people on this call. We all should be wanting each other's success. So all these flaws that we are hearing about each other, we're finding out about each other, it shouldn't be the end of it. It should be, how do we help each other build these out of these flaws? How do we give each other more solutions? How do we help each other become greater? Because we should never want to stop our growth. You know, we're so young, and we still have a lot of life to live ahead of us. So help each other now, help each other grow. And as we do that, then, you know, we will become better. Yep, that's all I got. Anybody have any last minute comments or anything that you want to put in? If not, then...